Destructive winds and rain sweeping the island of Guam brought by Typhoon Mawar. Mawar is expected to be one of the largest storms to hit the island in decades. The U.S. National Weather Service says powerful winds could possibly last until Thursday morning. Guam's Homeland Security of Civil Defense issued an extreme wind warning Wednesday afternoon, even as Mawar was downgraded to a typhoon. Ahead of Mawar's arrival, U.S. President Joe Biden declared a state of emergency to allow the territory to receive assistance from the federal government. U.S. forces also sent away ships and major equipment that could be damaged by the typhoon, which is expected to bring winds of 240 kilometers per hour. According to Landon Idlet, the warning coordination meteorologist for the National Weather Service in Guam, Typhoon Mawar follows the path of previous strong storms that struck the island, such as Pamela and Pongsona in 2002.
That's a Category 4, and this is looking like it could be the largest, most powerful typhoon to strike Guam in 20 years. So think back to 2002, we were struck by Typhoon Pongsona, which became a super typhoon immediately after passing Guam, causing significant damage to the island. This could be a similar storm.
Meantime, residents there say they are feeling the effects of the strong storm. Speaking to ANC, Patrick Lucis, president of the Filipino community in Guam, said authorities have announced mandatory evacuation for all residents.
At this time, we are all following the orders and the direction by our local government. At this time, our Governor Liam Guerrero has called for mandatory evacuation for all of our residents to take shelter. At this time, we are going to extreme wind warning is issued. We advise all to take cover at this time. We're passing the word on to the rest of our Filipino community and residents to take shelter. The peak of the storm is very dangerous and life-threatening at this time. Challenges right now is just to get in touch with our community, see what is it that we can do to prepare.
However, we do live right next to a jungle, and so we can see the wind blowing through the trees. There are a few trees that have been knocked down.
Lucis says there are over 50,000 Filipino residents in Guam as of January this year. So far, the typhoon is still outside of the Philippine area of responsibility. It may enter the country by Friday or Saturday morning. Weather Bureau Pagasa says Mawar may re-intensify into a super typhoon upon entering the Philippines, with maximum sustained winds reaching up to 205 kilometers per hour over the weekend. It may also have a direct effect in some areas in northern Luzon, but with a radius of over 300 kilometers, it could bring rains to various parts of the country.
Kung magpapatuloy ito at magiging mabagal pang pagkilos nito once na malapit na sa area ng Southern Taiwan, Extreme Northern Luzon, posible itong magpaibay ng habagat. Pag napag-ibay ang habagat, asahan natin mapag-ulan sa kanlurang bahagi ng Mimaropa, Visayas at Mindanao.